So, I have no idea why a blue circle is in the center of my video the entire way through. I didn't invite him. But hey, he's here to keep us company. So let's give him a warm Hadrix welcome. Also keeping me company today, I've got Chaos.
Hello.
Alright, so I have no idea what happened to my save file, but I lost a few turns. I don't have Brax. I don't have any heroes again.
I hate when that happens.
That's just the way it's gonna be now. Since this is post-commentary, I can let you know I've already played all this, and I know what happens. I'm not gonna spoil the ending, but this is gonna be crazy. I was actually gonna speed up the footage like last time when I was out of battles, but I put it in the editor and I found that it's not really necessary. This is, especially since I upped the cycles up to 7,000 on DOSBox, this doesn't need to be sped up really. It's a lot that's going on real fast.
This is Master of Magic, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, does this game have any relation to Might and Magic?
No, this was Microprose. This was the same company that made XCOM.
Okay. Because it looks just like Might and Magic.
Yeah, Might and Magic was...
On the surface, it looks a lot like Might and Magic.
I want to say 2K games, but I think they picked Heroes of Might and Magic up later. I'm not
certain... Well, there's Might and Magic, and then there's Heroes of Might and Magic.
Yeah, I'm not certain which company made them.
One's, more RPG, and the other one's like this.
Well...
And I always get them mixed up.
Not really like this. Heroes of Might and Magic is...
Worldview, running cities, shit like that. Yeah. It's
a strategy game, but it's
one's
not
a strategy
like...
game, another one's an RPG.
As a person who plays a lot of strategy games, I can say Heroes of Might and Magic has some really odd design choices about it.
It does. I do not play a lot of strategy games. I'm more for the action, but it's nice to sit down and play a strategy game every once in a while.
Yep. So I have these two fairies. I spent a ton of mana summoning them.
Okay.
And they cost me like 6 mana a turn just to have them.
Wow.
They can fly and they can shoot.
Well, it costs you 6 mana a turn. How much mana do you have every turn?
I'm producing after my upkeep cost 3. But bent all my resources to making mana. I'm not becoming more powerful. I'm not researching spells. All I'm doing is making MP.
You need to hope those fairies are worth it.
Fairies are pretty good. You can't attack them with a ground unit unless you cast web on them. Oh.
Well, I guess that does make them useful.
Mm-hmm. Also, being flying, they can travel over water and stuff.
That makes them more useful. Like, over the actual ocean water,
yep.
Or just over rivers and the
ocean.
So the whole thing. Okay. Nice.
This is a game where in the review I was doing wacky stuff like building warships and casting flight on them. So you just had flying warships shooting cannons at you.
I screwed up.
This game gives you more depth and has more in it, just more to it than almost any... No, than any other strategy game I've ever played to this day. It just has so much going on, so much you can do. The races are amazing. This is my first time playing Gnolls. I've been very impressed with the Gnolls, but some of the Mirran races especially, like the Dark Elves or the... I'll have to remember there's a Phantom Beast in there. I might be able to kill a Phantom Beast. It's not like so many of these things have like Demon Lords and crap in them, because I'm an impossible. But,
Well, that's the way to play. Pick the hardest difficulty and go for it.
The Mirran races are filled with stuff like, trolls. You can have 9 units of trolls, and, like this is a race. This is all their different stuff. Their swordmen, their spearmen, their war trolls, everything but their mammoths has regenerate. You could lose 8 guys in the battle, but as long as you win the battle, they're all back up and fully healed. Because they're regenerating. Oh. As a race.
God, fighting a frickin' necromancer with skeletons. Actually, that's worse than fighting a necromancer with skeletons.
Yeah, necromancy, I find that death is probably the weakest school of magic in this game.
I'm thinking of other games where it can turn into a real pain in the ass real fast.
Mm-hmm.
They're just replenishing their troops as they come and wipe you out.
Yeah.
Drives me nuts.
Gotta be careful of unicorns. They're not that tough, but they teleport for some reason.
What? Unicorns
that teleport.
That's just wrong. That's...
Freya here, she keeps planting cities of bug people. I hate bug people. Everyone hates bug people. And she's playing them. So she has all these bug people units running around, clack-ons. She's making cities of them. And I can't decide whether or not I'll burn them down later when I'm fighting her.
This just sounds like a horde army. Just a horde of bugs coming for you. It'll just overwhelm you with numbers.
You'd think that because of StarCraft, but... They'll overwhelm me with numbers no matter what they're playing on this difficulty.
Not only StarCraft, but also Warhammer 40K.
The Klakons...
They can't
build big, good buildings. They can't make universities or Parthenons or wizard towers.
So they have their base little unit, right?
Mm-hmm.
How quickly do they pump out the little unit?
Well, they produce about the same speed as anybody else produces spearmen. Well, most races. They have poison, so their units are poisonous. But the real reason everyone hates them is because when you make... when you conquer a Klakon city, I have these guys that have unrest. You can see I have, none in this town. They're all farmers and workers, but you get guys that are just rebels.
Yeah.
They won't work, they don't pay taxes.
Yeah.
You're just...
Yeah, the usual issue with conquering someone's town, yeah.
Okay. Klakons are more rebellious than any other race.
Wow.
Unless you're capitalist Klakon.
Are you serious?
I'm serious!
It is better to just burn their damn village to the ground.
And they always end up being... They're always in the game. Like, a lot of races you don't necessarily see, but you always seem to find Klakon, neutral Klakon. I found Freya's capital!
You gonna raise it to the ground?
If I get the forces to conquer it, it's not that well defended at the moment. If I get the forces capable of taking it, I would definitely keep her capital. Even if I burned all the other bug people out. But that's a city with a high population and a good number of buildings already in it. And also, it's sort of a trophy. I got your capital. If you take their capital, the wizard gets banished and has to come back into this world. So there's like 30 to 100 turns where they just can't do anything. That was a rebel there. So I know where her capital is. That's a big deal. I have my first Wolf Rider. This is the special unit of the Gnolls. He moves 3 spaces a turn.
Huh.
And on roads, you can move up to 6.
Gotta remember to build them roads. Watching this makes me want to play Civ 5 again.
I don't even know if Gnolls can make engineers and make roads or not. I have to check.
So are you, like, researching new magic and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Also, okay, so, I mean, it looks like a mix between Heroes of Might and Magic and Civ.
Because
I don't remember being able to build roads and engineers and Heroes of Might and Magic, but
yeah, it's
I
more
haven't played the newest iteration
it's
yet.
More like Civilizations with Magic. Okay, now this is where everything goes kinda to hell. Alright. I moved my fairies in the wave as warbears. That's one warbear. Sprites will have no problem killing one warbear. And that's, so I'm looking at which city I'm gonna conquer. This city is really important up north. The Lizardmen one is just nice to have, but the one up above is orcs, and for whatever reason in this game, orcs can build every kind of city, or every kind of building. So, since none of my other guys can build universities and all the other important things that I need, alchemist guilds. Having that orc city...
Orcs can have universities?
Yes. For some...
Hell?
These are not normal orcs. For some reason, they can build everything.
Those are some smart damn orcs.
I know. They're not really aggressive or good at... They're not orcs like what you think of orcs at all. They're just something different. Yeah, this is where I realized that I've got all these rebels in all these cities that they're not producing anything. I'm trying to click and go like, come on, be workers, be work. Wait a minute. Or be farmers. Wait a minute. I get what's going on. So I'm going to adjust my tax rate. I'm going to be merciful to them.
What'd you have it at before?
I had it at 30%. I moved it down to 20%.
Oh, okay.
So now there's still a bunch of rebels running around, but now I'm producing more.
Well, that's good.
Yep. So, yeah, that orc city is extremely valuable. I desperately need to conquer it and make some settlers, orc settlers, to make more orc cities, to propagate them, because the world needs more orcs. All right. So now, Merlin's going to attack me. It's my first time crossing swords with him.
He has
war bears.
One unit of war bears.
Yep. I don't have any MP on me, hardly at all. They caught me with just low on MP. But still, the war bears are half dead already. And he has web.
That's not good.
I was so mad when this happened. So angry.
Oh, that's weak.
That's the strongest component of my army. That was like, all I have elsewhere are just like spearmen and this one wolf rider. See, he didn't declare war on me. He's just, I'll just hit you once.
What a prick.
Now I'm in trouble.
Well, at least now you're producing 8 mana a turn instead of 2.
This is a small consolation after I sank 200 plus the upkeep cost into those sprites. Oh, man. Alright, so. Don't want to accidentally cast this on my spearmen over there. Okay. Heroism.
So what's heroism do?
That wolf rider is now max level.
Oh, shit.
And because I took the Warlord trait at the beginning of the game,
yeah,
my max level is one level higher. So, those Wolf Riders are extremely badass right now.
How long does heroism last for?
It's paying an upkeep on it. It's basically permanent.
Oh.
You can also cast it in battle just for the duration of a battle.
Okay.
It's pretty good. One of the reasons that I consider white the best color. That's the beginning of the game spell.
Damn.
On heroes have a way, way higher level cap, so if you cast heroism on a hero, they become badass, but not max level. Just, you know, a bunch of levels. Alright. So I'm trying desperately to scrape together enough mana to cast spells as I need them. I can spend up to 30 mana in one battle right now.
Where do you see that?
MP.
Oh, 26.
Yeah, mana crystals.
Okay.
So there's Merlin just sending shit ton of men all up into my peninsula. My peninsula that I haven't even finished conquering yet. Alright.
A whole bunch of multitasking needs to go on in these strategy games.
Three orc swordsmen versus my wolf riders. Every single guy in those units,
yeah,
is a guy who has separate hit points, attack power, and defense. So these four wolf riders, they have 9 attack right now. Well, that's 4 people hitting a 9. If you have really high defense, you can be like really hard to hurt. There's a first strike and 1,000 different, like, you know, things. So didn't even hurt me. This guy's got a level. He killed one of my 4 wolf riders. So now my wolf riders are actually weaker because there's less guys and less weapon. Yay! And now I own the orcs. And look, Freya has all this crap up here to, ground, I guess. Oh, first thing I do, I make a spearman. Just so I have something in the town.
Right.
Also, soldiers, if you have a bunch of guys in the town, they pacify the rebels and make them work.
That's
so,
useful.
Just keep a bunch of soldiers in town. Unfortunately, you have to feed soldiers, and that requires you to make farmers, so... Yeah, I don't think summon creatures actually work. That's two different heroes she's gotten. Both of them are archers.
That's not good.
Machine is very bad at using heroes. They don't make artifacts for them to equip. They generally don't spell them up. And they generally don't live long enough to get high level. So, heroes aren't too much of a worry. I mean, they're still a hero, but...
Those damn bears, on the other hand, those are going to be an issue.
Well, don't want to go in there. Now, I try to decide whether or not one turn is worth $8.
Not really.
I really wanted to conquer those Lizardmen, because I see all these Merlin troops and Freya troops, and I don't want them taking that Lizardmen city with the Halberders in it.
Right.
I want that. I want this whole peninsula. So, I went ahead and sped up the Spearman so I can run out, and now I need more food again. I'm always trying to get away with having the least amount of farmers possible.
Oh, yeah.
And look! More bug people cities! Now my capital is getting half production out of three of its squares. Because they put bug people next to it.
Wow.
Thanks, Freya! It's a good strategy to disrupt me, anyway. That one will get burned. I promise you, that city will get burned. Oh, look. Freya attacked me.
Oh,
bug
no.
People. Looks like a unit of swordsmen. She just smelt them up with giant strength. They're actually, pretty tough. But gnolls are apparently really tough. I've been very impressed with... I don't remember Wolf Riders being that great, but... They're really kicking ass this game.
Well, you got them in max level.
Well, my spearman is still hiking around exploring. And I come running down to try to take this city over here.
So those bears just sitting there?
Those bears just sitting there for some reason. I wonder what they're plotting. She still hasn't declared war on me. She's just throwing guys at me.
It's so passive aggressive.
Spearmen versus spearmen. Who do you think will win? Bug people or gnolls?
Gnolls.
Gnolls have 5 attack. They have 2.
Gnolls win.
Yes, they're poisonous. It doesn't matter. I think they have higher defense. It doesn't matter. Gnolls are really, really deadly at those early units.
What does poison even do?
I have to read its stats. You've got like poison 1, poison 2, poison 3,
yeah, okay.
Poison 4. It deals damage after they hit you. I'd have to read the description to see the exact stuff. Merlin's got a lot of men up here. That can't be good. He's not plotting anything good for me. And him and Freya have been having peace treaties and wizard pacts and things the whole time. So, as much as I wish the two would fight each other, that would be amazing. Okay, they just sent men into that city that I was about to conquer. Not sure. I know cavalry have first strike. I'm not sure if my wolf riders have first strike or not. I have to see.
It's a lot of spearmen.
Yep. So I believe I saw fairies attack that city. Okay, there's a regular swordsman, not halberdman. And I saw their guys attack, and they all lost. They all died. This city is just filled with swordsmen that have levels and everything. But right now, they're injured and knocked around. So I'm gonna go for it.
Take it.
This is really risky, and I'm doing no save scumming, no takebacks. If I lose my wolf riders, they're just dead, like my fairies. This is the only unit I've got left! So I'm making decisions whether or not to cast Holy Armor, Holy Weapon, rain fiery death on these things, and I decide I'm going to keep my healing. Healing is another reason I consider white to be the best school of magic.
Right. So you have 9 attack and they have 4 or 5.
But they have more guys per unit.
True.
My guys also have more hit points than they do. I can count, but usually they've got about 8 per stack. But I mean, this one might have less.
Well, looks like they only got 5 per stack.
No, it's 6. They have 6. I just counted.
So, troop placement really plays a role.
Yeah, we're...
When you're on the battlefield.
We think that being on hills makes your guy stronger, especially if you're defending with spearmen or something.
Yeah.
That's been the assumption I've been under since I was a kid. I've never actually been certain, but that's what we think. So now I have a really decent lizardman city that doesn't have any buildings in it, but it's got a population of 5.
Is that a good population?
It's a population.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I hadn't burned down that building, but, you know, war, stuff happens. Guys just randomly slip up and torch buildings we didn't tell them to.
What the hell was that?
Just turned a desert into a grassland. That's Freya at work. I want that spell. My favorite thing about green nature magic, you can change the terrain, and you can even transform resources. You can be like, I turned this silver into a minthral mine.
That's useful.
Mm-hmm. Green also gets the best summons.
Hmm.
A lot of other cool stuff. Like web. Web and war bears. Those are green. Alright. So, this is where the game is about to make a turn. This is where things are about to go crazy. So I went ahead and I made 2 spearmen up here. As much as I want bowmen, I need to build granaries and farmers' markets and general infrastructure buildings in this city. Gotta build up the population! Though archers would be really nice right now. So I got mana, I got gold, things seem to be going smoothly. Soon I'll be making a second wolf rider, I'm making a farmer's market in my capital. It's just like basic infrastructure stuff that, you know, I can't believe how much trouble I'm having before I've even got my infrastructure in place.
Yeah.
This is a huge world. 2 guys must have started right near me at the beginning.
So how many other mages are there total?
There are 4 wizards, including myself.
Huh. And
one of which
started that close to
one
me.
Of which is on another world. Yep. Alright. Thinking about big spells, but I decide to pass. Okay, here we go. You ever this? You ever this? What do you think Merlin, that dick, is gonna do?
Probably start attacking you.
He's gonna declare war on me! And you know that Orc City? He's going for that one first! All I have are two level nothing spearmen. Well, they start level one because I'm a warlord. That's it. That's all they got. So I have healing, or I could cast heroism. I could do two doses of healing, or I could do one heroism, or I could cast, you know, there's a few other spells I could cast, but... Prayer. What's that pretty much sealed the deal.
What's prayer do?
You see how there's eight guys in every spearman unit he's got? Prayer gives plus one to every guy. Plus one to attack, defense, resistance, maybe even accuracy, I'm not sure.
So, if you cast heroism on one of your spearmen, they would be able to take those guys out? Even though it makes them max level.
He did this, then he even threw a spell up on one of his guys. So, that's the question. Is heroism enough on these orc spearmen to take out all these nomad spearmen? You're gonna put stone skin on that one. So I generally consider that spearmen are better on the defense than offense. This is something I've never been exactly certain of, but I think. So I generally let the enemy attack me. And that's the answer. So now, he owns my orc city.
Great.
I don't need to kill a single one of his men.
Really?
Really?
I got entire... Damn.
No. I just get spawned.
Well, that's ass right there.
At this point, Merlin declares war on me! Actually declares war on me, and he completely destroys the city. He
really?
Just genocides the orcs. The orcs that I needed. There's no taking it back. It's gone! He hates me. Look at that.
Wow.
He's still in a peace treaty with Freya, too. Freya hasn't declared war on me. She's just been...
A pain in the ass.
Yeah, she's just been opportunately picking at me, and I can't, you know, retaliate.
So those are both Merlin's units.
Uh-huh. Plus the stack he had up there that burned the city, plus the bears on that hill. My capital's over there with only a couple spearmen to defend it, but I'm gonna go for it! I'm just gonna go for it!
French team of everything.
Fire elementals. And those are swordsmen and spearmen. Merlin's got all the best spells. I've been so busy making mana, I haven't researched a spell all game.
Really?
Only have the ones I started with and the ones I traded for.
Great, how many of those is he gonna pull out of his ass?
As many as he feels like. They have 12 attack.
At least there's only one of them, though.
A whole bunch of hit points.
Well, your wolf riders aren't really taking any damage from the regular guys. The fire elemental is going to be an issue, though.
I've been surprised at how badass. Yeah, fire elemental does, has fire breathing, which is a type of first strike.
It didn't seem like that had much of a problem with the fire elemental. The hell, you need more wolf riders, man.
I do! Yay! That doesn't make up for the lost orc city, but I got a point of fame for the battle.
Well, that's good.
Yeah. That's all my capital's got. Two spearmen.
Great. How long would it take to produce another wolf rider?
Well, I'm finishing the farmer's market. No, I started on a Wolf Rider.
Great.
Chart looks pretty bleak, don't it?
Yep. Looks like Freya's moving her units in, too.
Just can't get a break, can I?
Of course not. Big game wouldn't be fun.
Well, better not attack that.
Oh, great.
So my guy still needs to heal up, so...
Merlin's dick. What the hell?
So I rush production where I can. But Merlin's an even bigger dick, because he's a wizard. And he can do terrible things to the map. Like that.
The hell did that just do?
You just corrupted the land with chaos magic.
Great, so that probably just killed your production on that tile, huh?
Yep. Until I can get a bunch of shaman together to purify it. Boy, orcs could make shaman. Oh! Gnolls don't even have shaman. Thankfully, lizardmen do if I build a shrine. So I'll be able to purify it with lizard men at least.
Well, that's good.
Wow. Man. So, shaman. They're a crappy ranged attacker, but they are a healer, so all the units that are stacked with them recover injuries faster outside of battle.
Okay.
Does nothing in battle for me, but...
Right.
High men get priests. Priests, I believe, can actually cast healing. Get for eating my sprites. Freaking war bears.
Yep. Well, I gotta head back to work.
Alright.
So,
see ya.
I'll be back.
I decided it'd be better to protect my city than to take more revenge upon Merlin at this moment, because Freya can't be trusted. She can't be trusted. That's a lot of spelled up bears. So I'm pretty much just gonna sacrifice these spearmen. Because this fight's really about taking these guys on one at a time. Not getting ganged up on. Bears. turns out the wolf riders love eating bear meat with a side of bugs. Still didn't declare war. Still got nothing to trade her with for, though. Alright. That's a lot of stuff. And my guys were all beaten up because I didn't heal. If I change the spearmen, I lose all the work I've done so far on the shrine. Because unlike in the more modern civilization games and stuff, your production value is just a production value. Whatever you change it to, that's what you're producing. So, changing producing stuff is... You always have to take that into consideration, what you might be losing in your production. That's me seriously considering adding holy armor to this unit, but it'd take 3 turns. No good. Here we go! Fairies actually worry me more than everything else. I don't know why he put stone skin and holy armor on them, though. That's a really, really weird strategy machine. Now, I don't want enemies walking through my town, because if the enemy units walk through my town, they'll kill my people and burn my buildings. I try to keep that stuff at a minimum. But in this case, I've really got to stand on this, just away from the fairies and up on this hill. The further I am away from the fairies, the harder it is for ranged units to hit me. There's a lot of tactical depth, a ridiculous amount of stuff that took into consideration when we made this game. And that's really what I feel makes it sets it apart from all the other strategy games I've played. I mean, in Civ, battles just are instantaneous. They're just done. Like, you put your 2 stacks together, you just start throwing men back and forth. There's no tactical combat. They tried to fix that in Civ 5, and I think with other players, there'd be a great deal of depth, but against the machine, when I played it, now, I didn't have the expansion packs, maybe they got it better, but when I was playing it, the machine just didn't know how to use the tactical depth in Civ 5. Like, I was playing around the machine on the hardest difficulty, and winning. And yet, in Civ 4, if I tried that nonsense, the hardest difficulty setting, the machine just owns me. So I'm in a lot of trouble now. I have no MP to heal with, and I'm ridiculously outnumbered. If I lose this city, I'm... Ooh. My only wolf rider. You guys know what the stakes are, I don't have to say it. So once again, I am underestimating just how awesome the gnolls are. I was actually considering whether or not I should try to take the fairies out to make sure that... Because if all he has are summons on the field at the end of battle, he doesn't actually take the city. And he tore up my barracks. Great. Look at this, more men next to my capital with only his spearmen to defend it! Oh my gosh! Buy it. Just buy it. There you go. Sorry, sometimes I have to tell my past self what to do. It, you know, it's one of those things. So, nothing in this city? My guy's all beaten up? I have to go for it! Must protect my capital. Mosquitoes. Alaska's full of mosquitoes in the summer. Alright. Finally, I'm gonna build another unit of Wolf Riders. 9 turns. I'll buy them sooner than that. Yay, more bug people. And I see another unit. Hero unit. Fritz is taking crazy risks now. This is borderline madness! To still be trying to protect that city, but I feel like I have to hold on to all this stuff, because if I start losing cities, while the machine is ever growing bigger and more powerful, the game is sort of lost, especially on Impossible. You have to keep advancing. You have to keep building and getting more stuff. Otherwise, you just get left in the dust. And next thing you know, the machine's got great worms and crap you can't even deal with. Decisions. Yay, shaman. Shaman are surprisingly ineffective, largely because they come in units of 4 and archers come in 6. Slingers come in 8. That's why slingers are the best unit in the game, but only halflings get them. Slingers aren't the best units in the game. They're only amazing if you have the right spells to put on them. By themselves, they're really good, and cheap, and expendable. But you start casting spells that increase their attack power, and they're making 8 attacks, so +1 to attack powers, +1 to every one of those 8 guys. And that's when they become the best, when you have stuff like Lionheart to put on. Now here's a game. I'm supposed to get a chance to cast spells every turn, even when I'm paralyzed like that. The game didn't give it to me. The game's all like, no, you can't cast spells. It just didn't let me do it. You're not nice of it. Oh no. You're not getting away from me. Come on back here, Dolo. Or should I say Bishan in disguise? Bishan always has the nobility trait. He's the only hero that always has that trait. He pays you 10 bucks a turn just to have him. So, taking away Bishan is, also hurts him financially. Although not much. On this setting, he's got, like, all the money in the world. Not that nice. Oh. Now we got a problem. I should just be glad that the machine doesn't dispel my heroism. Probably because I'm not fighting anyone in blue.
She loves to cast Dispel Truth on you all the time.
So, the heroism Bashan is worth about 1/4 of a unit of Wolf Riders. That's the lesson we take away from that battle. Ho ho ho, hellhounds. Next to my capital. We're coming near the end of this video. What do you think's gonna happen? They're sitting right next to my capital. How do you think this video's gonna end? Oh, no fair reading the title of the video. I am one turn away from my capital with my wolf riders. And I'll be able to make another. I'll have another one coming out real soon. I'll be able to buy the last of it. Stomp the last of Merlin's forces on my peninsula. So many spearmen and tries to use the militarily. I make spearmen because they don't cost any money to upkeep, just food, and I can leave them in a city. That's the only reason I make them. I never try to use them aggressively. Yet, here they are, throwing all these spell ups on them would cost more MP than the spearmen is worth. Oh well. So I'm moving that guy to protect my null settlement over there with all the bowmen next to it. Because I want to protect that spot. But those bowmen are right next to the city right this second, so all there are is lizardmen to protect it. And here we go! Spearmen versus swordsmen, which is a higher tier unit, and hellhounds. Oh boy! Good news is my guys have picked up a few levels just because you get one experience point every turn for all your units no matter what, just flat, so your guys are constantly like training and leveling up just over time. So at least my guys have a couple levels on them. But they're still outnumbered by a higher class unit right now. That only goes so far. All right, that's all I can do. That was my MP. And there's Hellhounds. Okay, I can also put a holy weapon on my spearmen. Yay! Well, folks, this is it. I can put my guys on a hill. Spearmen defensively on a hill. Yes! I'm still in the game. Honestly, I can't believe I won that battle. It was so close. And now my Gnoll settlement. They were trying to genocide the Gnolls as well this time. The Nomads are Nazis this game. Anyway. Merlin. Oh. Spearmen don't have large shields. Swordsmen have shields to protect them from range attacks. Now he put prayer on all of his bowmen. All I can do is move away so that they have lower chance of hitting, lower accuracy. I should mention that like everything else, every single guy in that unit is making a separate attack roll every time they shoot. I believe it was a French general who said the best armor is distance. Surprisingly good tactical advice for France. Although, it fits in with the general, stereotype of French warfare. Hey, I'm a fourth French. French and German are the only people I get to make fun of. And I don't do it very often. So. Bowman. Level 1 bowmen are not very good. When they gain a few levels, they up their attack power and their accuracy, but they're never really great. Even high elves with their long bowmen aren't that great. They're okay. And this is where the machine rage quits. Yeah. Right here. That's it. The machine just quit. It's over. Because I'm not doing any takebacks, I decided I'd kind of try to, you know, I wouldn't save at all except in between things. Well, that was a terrible and foolish mistake of mine. Not saving all the time while playing Master of Magic. I don't know what I was thinking. But I didn't save once! I didn't save once this entire Let's Play! So, what do you guys think I should do? Should I just go back to, just load and pick back up back when I had 2 fairies and hadn't even conquered the peninsula yet? Or should I start a new game? What do you guys think I should do? What do you guys want to see? Should I do 2 episodes to make up for this next week? Yeah, just tell me what you think in the comments below. As you can imagine, I was frustrated and unhappy with the results of this. Because I was honestly surprised I'd held on to it as narrowly as I did. I mean, this has been a ridiculously close game. So, till next time, this is Hadrix signing off. The top link leads to the next part of the Master of Magic Let's Play. The bottom left link leads to an old review, as one of the very first reviews I ever did was for Master of Magic, and that'll take you right to the silly little video. And the bottom right link takes you to my Memories of Mana Let's Play.